evolving.
So yeah. We're on to game one here.
Game one.
Another matchup I'm pretty used to seeing. We got Lucina versus Wolf starting off on our brand new home for everybody to enjoy, for those of us who weren't in PM.
Yep.
We got PS2.
Yes. And this is a best of five. This is top eight. I believe we are in the money.
No, I'm pretty sure he said best of three. They were only doing winners, losers, grands as...
Really?
Yeah, that's what I thought I heard. So we'll get confirmation once we see somebody win two.
Yeah, but I'm pretty sure normally once we get past into the finals, that's when we start counting best of fives. That's why I'm a little confused. But
I think it might just be because it's the first day, you know, it's a little condensed. But that aside, we have a pretty dead even game here. Koga doing a really solid job of kind of outboxing Zoo. Even though he's a little bit behind percent, he's not really letting Zoo get max damage that he could be getting off of this stuff. But Zoo does have him at kill percent, and Koga needs to be very careful.
Yeah. So the one thing I've learned about Wolf today is that Wolf can kill super early, but the moment you throw him off, he's pretty much dead.
Yeah, he has a piss poor recovery, which Koga will definitely be trying to abuse at some point. Now, if you don't throw out a hitbox early enough, that side B can spike you for your troubles of trying to go get Wolf, so you do need to be careful.
Wow, I didn't know it was a spike, actually. That's pretty crazy.
Yeah. Oh. And there. That's exactly what I was talking about. Koga is very used to the spaces. You know, this is no different.
Yeah.
He's going to try and abuse your recovery every chance he gets. And that's something Zoo needs to be very careful with going into this.
Yeah, and especially with like you said, a piss poor recovery, it is not easy to avoid that sword.
Exactly. And Koga kind of getting a little bit of momentum here. As you see, even he has a stock lead up, so he's trying to go out there and get that early gimp. 157% if you get killed.
Ooh, the nair.
Oh, that's... Okay, Zoo saved his jump, but he wasn't close enough to get back. And that's going to be an unfortunate SD for Zoo. And Koga's going to run away with that.
You really hate to see that kind of thing. But it doesn't look like it's killing Zoo too much when composer-wise. I want to see if maybe Koga gets something started here.
Yeah. You know, Zoo, this is in this game, the pace of this game, these stocks have been flying. So this is nowhere out of reach for Zoo. All he needs is just get good momentum, carry him all the way to the end, just crack on as much damage as possible. Kind of like right now, just not letting him touch the ground. But Koga's Fair finally able to get him out of it.
Yeah, it's kind of hard for Wolf to get started. I didn't watch it, but I've seen Leffen call Wolf Marth with a gun, like melee Marth with a gun. But against a sword, unfortunately, that's not going to be as...
Exactly. Like that applies to many different things, but not that time. Unfortunately, that down smash wasn't close enough to seal that stock out. You see Zoo really doing a good job of keeping Koga trapped at the ledge here. Gets the anti-air up tilt, but doesn't kill.
Wow, that up tilt was super smart, sending Koga in a really bad position.
Luckily Koga did an SD there. That would have that would have been great for Zoo to be able to get himself back in his game.
Wow.
Koga at 134. He did still have his jump, though.
Yeah.
He's barely able to make it back.
And Zoo is in a very dangerous position now, especially facing the ledge with Rage. Koga has Rage. 82% is definitely kill percent for Wolf.
Yeah, it's just so frightening watching a Wolf dash dance around you like that. But because Koga is so well composed when it comes to spacing out with Lucina, really get too committed. Went above the ledge, and Zoo prepared with the nair to be able to take that take care of that stock.
And it looks like the buff to Wolf from Brawl, giving him Fox's nair, is actually proving very well for his character.
Oh, 100%. He's been able to, Zoo's been doing a good job of kind of fading in and out with the nair, and being able to kill off stage with it to rip a jump is so good. But unfortunately, Zoo now off stage. See what Koga does about the ledge trap.
Oh, wow. Okay. Scared me.
That would have been curtains if he got caught by the F smash at the ledge there.
Yeah. Koga. Oh, that was it. That was it, man. Zoo, even at 150, probably has a better chance of taking a stock now than he has this whole set, really.
Yeah, with all this rage, he has been able to bring this back. What's a read on the roll with the up tilt? That's going to just delete that stock. We're going to see game one going in.
What's up? Yeah, sure thing. But right now, that up tilt, actually, I didn't realize how strong up tilt was. That's really good.
Unlike Barth and company, Lucina has knockback and damage across the entire sword. There's no difference in where you hit, where she'll have end result. So, kind of putting her above Marth, honestly, in this game. It's kind of weird to say that Marth is one of the worst or one of the lesser swordsmen compared to the other ones. Like, even people, such as Shulk. Have gotten so many buffs. Probably, honestly, the best swordsman in the game right now.
So we actually talked to Koga about this. He gave me a full ranking. He said top three. He said...
Koga opinions are sus.
It is a Koga opinion. He said Krom, Lucina, Ike, I believe.
Okay, he changed it because we were talking about it on the ride here.
Yeah.
And he originally had He had a pretty interesting list.
Yeah, no, he was telling me on Saturday too. Probably the same list you were talking about before.
It's been changed up. All right, but back onto this though. We got hazardless Smashville. You know, the no more Smashville with moving platform because we're universally on no hazards. Kind of making it a smaller Yoshi's Island-esque layout.
Ooh, the up B.
That's the up B. Doesn't matter even though that he didn't get a stage spike. He had no jump available left.
Yeah, and it's up special. I can't remember the name. Proving to be really just awful. Like,
yeah, you know, that's where you have to get rid of Wolfman. You don't want him to be comfortable and relaxed. You want to make sure he's pressured and feels terrible trying to recover.
And Dancing Blade, I actually love the new Dancing Blade. I think it's a
really?
Welcome addition. Yeah, I think just granted, you know, you see more people spamming it, but like
ask Koga about how he feels about that new set. Honestly, in my opinion, like it benefits some, but it's terrible for others. Mm. And you know, if Koga actually traded with that side B off the stage, Zoo just would have went into free fall. So I don't know if Koga was trying to ferret or just give up a sacrificial stock.
Yeah.
That would have been pretty interesting if that was in his mindset.
Yeah, it's actually really interesting to see how. Like I know some of you guys all train together, but I was watching Chavo before, and Chavo really knows when to trade.
Yes.
Yeah, that's like that's what I've really noticed.
A big thing in this game is understanding acceptable damage, much like you know Melee and PM had to deal with, and also parrying. Parrying is going to be the biggest portion of defense people need to get used to, but you can't parry that. That up smash is going to take that stock out. And Koga putting Zoo at his potential winner side life.
Mm. So the one thing I haven't seen parries that much at all. The only person I've seen parry is Viscos all day today.
And yeah, well done to Viscos, by the way. He's looking solid. We'll talk more about him afterwards, but you know, so far this whole set has just been completely changed into Koga's pace with the way that he wants Zoo to approach him. He's been getting a lot of small trades and just racking up the damage as such. Zoo can definitely sit out the stock. F tilt not going to do it, but Zoo really needs to take control of this match because Koga is continuously reading these texts in place and getting these side Bs, and he's racking up a lot of free damage.
Oh, wow.
That might be his jump.
That was a super smart.
Oh, good air dodge away to avoid that because that would have been all she wrote.
Yeah, that would have been it. Okay, good nair, good nair. Mm-hmm. Get him back in the game.
As we were talking about before with the nair, Zoo trying to feel himself a little bit, get that taunt off. I'm looking forward to the first person to do a taunt cancel Wario like booty shake into waft. I'm hunting for someone to do that, so please, somebody do that.
I know there's not many Wario mains at all. I don't think he's very good in this game, actually.
We'll talk more about him after, too, because he did get some unique changes with one also big nerf. But again, back on this, you know, Zoo currently off stage. He does still have his jump.
Oh, that was a poor decision, in my opinion. Mm. But either way, he's on ledge now. Bad decision.
Able to roll himself back into center stage. He did get him out of his jump, but he doesn't get it. And that's an overcommitment. And Zoo's going to SD. And Koga is going to take that 2-0. And that answers the question we had before. Who was the best of three?
Would feel bad if it wasn't, but they seem very convinced that it is.
Yeah.
Either way, Lucina looking very good in this game, actually.
Oh, absolutely. You know, like I said, you know, Marth may have had a lot of changes happen to him, but Lucina is almost exactly the same. Like, there's not much that really altered Lucina overall. You know, the side B is a little bit different, yes.
Yeah.
A lot of the Lucina players not a huge fan of that side B because you got a lot more off the old one. But base knockback and to be able to harass people off stage with that new air dodge mechanic, really strong.
So, okay.
Lucina's still looking really good.